I work with FIRST to help all teams, coaches, mentors, volunteers. One of the things that FIRST has been working on is what's called a fundraising toolkit. The fundraising toolkit has a whole bunch of different sections in it about, you know, doing outreach or fundraisers, business plan, all that stuff is in there. It's the first few sections are actually due to come out in a few weeks. And one of the sections is what I'm going to go over today, which is section four, how to really market yourself for sponsors. Once the toolkit comes out, it will be on the FIRST website under the FRC section, and I highly encourage you guys to check that out. They'll have templates out there for business plans, for fundraising, for everything. So I gave everybody, or most of you guys have the handout. We're going to go over that first. This model is what FIRST Marketing uses when they go out to get sponsorships for main headquarters. There are four sections to it. The first thing is the point of entry. So you really need to know who you're going to approach, whether it's a bank or whether it's an engineering firm or whether it's whatever the company is. You want to really know what that company does, what kind of outreach they do, what kind of interest they have, what their employees do. As much information you have before going into the meeting with them. The second thing is the emotional hook. We have a really easy way of doing that. You bring a robot. Bring as many kids as you can on your team, in your team uniform. Tell them anything and everything about your team. That's that emotional hook. Tie it to them somehow. If you're going to an engineering firm, that's really easy to connect with what you're doing and what they do. Okay. One of the biggest things that you want to do on that point of entry is capture their names. Get their business cards, get whoever's in charge, get whatever you can from them so you have a way to contact them in the future. The hardest part about this is unless they ask you, how can we help, the real main point of that point of entry is just to establish some type of relationship, okay? Going in there and directly asking for money instantly is a very, very hard thing to do, and it's not advisable at all. You want to make sure that they actually know that you want to be kind of partners with them, okay? The easiest way is to build that relationship. After a little bit of time has gone by, you know, a week maybe, you just got to fill it out, you're going to do the follow-up, and that's where that captured name comes in play. Call them up, email them, ask them if they have any more questions about your team, your robot, or anything else. Listen to everything they have to say and try to get them out to some outreach. Try to get them to a competition. Try to get them to anything you can to continue that relationship. Third is when we actually ask for money. Once you feel that that relationship is built and or they ask, you know, what can we do? That's when the official asking for money comes into play. So there are a few things we can ask for. Money is one of them. What else can we ask for? Anybody? No? Yes. Materials, raw materials. What's that? Mentors? What's that? Services. What else? What if you're a brand new team or a team that lost a facility? Could you ask for a facility, space, tools, equipment? I mean, anything. It doesn't, just because you need sponsors doesn't mean that it has to be money, okay? You can then save that money that you have for things like registration, okay? The other trick is instead of asking for a large sum of money, you know, we need $3,000. Ask for $1,000, but for 3 years. Okay. It's a lot easier to say $1,000 than it is $3,000. It's a smaller number, and now you have a continuing thing. So you can go back and say, okay, we're ready to start competing again. You know, you guys have signed on for 3 years. You know, we're ready for that. Okay. Keep them involved throughout the season as well. Get them in their shop. Get them in your shop. Watch that. Let them watch you build. Get them at your competition. Make sure that you put their name on your shirt, put their name on your robot. That kind of thing will help keep them as a continual sponsor. And the last part, which is really the another really important part, probably the most important part, is introduce others. It's really easy once you have that relationship to say, do you know of any other companies in our area that might be willing to jump on as well? Okay, because if you have 10 sponsors that are all for $1,000, you have $10,000. That's easier to do than one sponsor for $10,000. Okay, so the more sponsors you have, the better off and the better position you have. So if you lose one sponsor for the next year, you're not hurting as much as, you know, having one big sponsor and losing that sponsor. Okay? The other thing that you can do is all of your parents work for a company, right? That's probably where I would start, because there's already a tie there. There's already an in there. So instead of trying to go to cold entry into a company that you don't know, that's the easiest way to start, a place to start. So going into what to do at a presentation, the first thing really is, what do you do to prepare? And I talked about that a little bit initially, but the biggest thing is you know, bring your robot, wear your team shirts, do anything that you would do to prepare for a competition as far as what you individually do, and go there like you're going to a competition. Okay? Gracious professionalism, that's a big thing. Not only outside of first, but or not only in first, but outside of first as well. Make sure that everybody that's going to the presentation understands what you're going there for. Okay? What the goal is of just that meeting. You know, so that way nobody's discouraged coming out knowing the fact that we didn't get any money. Because that's not the goal of that initial meeting. Some do's and don'ts. Bring as much information, team information, as you have. Bring any handouts, any pamphlets that you can make. A lot of teams have the trifold pamphlets that tells people all about their team, the history of their team, history of first. If you need marketing tools like that, they're all downloadable on the first website. There's a marketing tab, you can download all of the pamphlets. Make one for first and make one for your team. Make sure you have multiple copies, that way you can give them to whoever's at the meeting. Talk about the partnership and really ask for that contact. You know, those are really key things that you want to make sure you do. A few things that you don't want to do are have your cell phone on. That would be horrible for the cell phone to go off and, you know, right there and while somebody's talking. Don't bring food with you. It's a common mistake that teams for some reason make. They'll have kids sitting in the back and they'll be eating chips or something else. It's kind of annoying, especially if you're trying to really make an impression on the potential sponsors. Try to make eye contact with everybody that's in the room as much as possible. And try to, you know, speak clearly and distinctively so they can understand what you're saying. If you're very quiet and you mumble, it's difficult to hear what you're trying to present. As much as possible, reduce fidgeting. You know, hand gestures and things sometimes can be a distraction. I have a hard time with it. That's why I'm holding my tablet. You know, bring something like that. If you're going to bring papers and read off the paper, that's fine. You know, that's one thing that you got to try to prevent. Focus on partnership and not just funding. You know, like I said, you know, hopefully I say it enough. The main goal of getting a sponsor is getting them more involved with your team than just donating some money. If you do that, you won't lose your sponsors. They'll continue to fund, and they'll continue to help your team out. Give them a few minutes on the robot if you can. Bring them in and let them control your robot. Bring your robot in a control system. Let them drive your robot around. Once they see what you are doing, it's really going to hook them and get them to want to help you out. And don't be shy to ask. If you feel that you do have that connection, don't be shy to ask. And the easiest way to ask is not to just ask for money. It says, you know, ask something like, we are really in need of help. Is there anything that you might be able to provide us? Okay, that's really open-ended question. They may see that as different than just money. They get pitched for money all the time. But they don't realize that their scrap material, their scrap pile there, that they've just been recycling, are perfect size pieces for your robot. They were going to just recycle it. You know, instead of recycling, now they're going to get a donation out of it. They can actually get a write-off on that. They may not know that, you know. Or a lot of times engineers are stuck doing the same thing over and over and over again. Giving them the opportunity to help engineer a robot is something, the reason why they went into that career field. So asking them to be mentors would be, you know, for a lot of them, what is actually interesting. That's why a lot of us are mentors. It's because it gives us a chance to be a kid again, you know, be able to do something that's what we miss. We feel we're missing. Make sure that you are professional with the words that you use, with the clothes that you wear. Obviously, you want to be in your team shirts, but that doesn't mean team shirts and cutoff jeans. Okay, you know, be at least casual clothing, okay? Don't have your hair all crazy. Comb your hair, you know, make it so you are presentable. You know, people laugh at that stuff, but it really does happen. That's why it's in here, because we asked teams do's and don'ts, and these are the things that they came to us with. Some suggestions for pre-presentation research. Here's some things that you can do before you go in. Find out who the main point of contact is. That's very important. I won't mention companies or teams or anything else, but recently going to a sponsor, trying to find a sponsor, teams were talking to a particular person as part of education outreach. Is that a person that you want to ask and pitch for money? Anybody? No? Probably not. It might not be that person. You know, somebody that's in the finance, or maybe the VP or somebody along that line would probably be a better person. Okay. How does a company benefit from the partnership? You want to tell them anything and everything you can based on the knowledge you have about their company. And that's hard to do unless you know what they're doing. What extra information should be in a sponsor packet? You should have some type of sponsor packet, and that's going to be part of that fundraising toolkit. And in there, you might have to add in a page extra that's geared towards that type of company, whether it's a company that you are hoping to get money from, like a bank or some other thing that's not a technical type company, or a technical type company you're trying to get materials or a mentor from. You want to make sure that you have that extra information that ties them to your team. Ask them when it's okay to follow up. You can do that. I mean, can we follow up with you? And they'll say yes or no. If they say yes, say when would be the best time to do that. Don't be afraid to ask these questions. They are used to being pitched all the time. So there's no reason why you can't do what the larger companies are already doing. And when you're doing the research, find out if there's any similar companies that might be already funding a team. They might be funding teams already, so it might be a little harder to get them as a sponsor. Or they might not even know about FIRST altogether. That's a huge difference in the knowledge that you need to bring with you. To a meeting. You might bore them talking about FIRST if they already know what it is. Okay? Or they may not know what it is, and you don't want to kind of glaze over the fact of what FIRST is all about. What's the FIRST mission? You know, what FIRST stands for? Those are very basic things that we all know. but they may not. The other things that you can bring with you, which you should already have, are things like a team history. Okay, that's an important thing to have. How long have you been a team? What have you been doing as a team? What awards have you won? How far have you gone? Have you gone to championships? What was it like? That kind of stuff they might ask you, or you might want to just tell them. Team sponsor benefits. What's going to benefit them for being a sponsor? Because everybody, every company out there is the same way. They want to know what's in it for them. And if you can't tell them that, then they might not be interested in sponsoring. Okay. You want to do, before you go to these companies, you want to do mock training sessions in your shop. Have somebody come in, an adult come in as the sponsor. Make up a scenario for the companies and have kids pitch each one and make them different levels. That way you get the practice of what you're supposed to say, what you're supposed to do. You don't want to go in your cold and hope that you're going to know everything and kind of be lost when you're standing up in front of the crowd. Okay. Some crowds may be one or two people, and some companies may have a whole department that comes in. You don't know. So you have to be prepared for everything. So practice as much as you can in your shop. So at that point, I don't want to go too far into the other sections of the toolkit, but are there any questions? So I go over one more area, but are there any questions so far? No? All right, so the other thing is how do I find sponsors? How do I look in my area and find sponsors? Easiest way is Google Maps. Go to Google Maps and type in things like engineering, and you'll find all the engineering firms in your area. You might recognize a few, and you probably won't recognize most of them, because a lot of the engineering firms are little tiny engineering firms, not big companies. The other thing that you can do are think about what else does our team need. Well, you guys all have team t-shirts, right? So type in t-shirts. Find out if they'll sponsor you by giving you t-shirts. Printing costs for free, or setup costs for free. Other things you might need. Software, for example. Find out the software companies in your area. Use those key terms that you want to find that you guys know that you struggle with. Type it in and do a search on it. It's the easiest way to find sponsors. When you look up the different people, do a Google search on that company, and that's how you can find about their history. Go to their website. You can also find out if they have been a sponsor of teams by doing a Google search. Type in that team, the company name, and type in First Robotics. And you'll see that they sponsor First Robotics teams, or they don't. Because everybody has every team has a website, right? Right? Do you guys put your sponsor names on your websites? Yeah? So a Google search will find that. So you'll be able to easily see if companies are sponsors or not. Any questions? Nothing? Has anybody had experience going into companies? Raise your hands. No one's gone to a company and asked for money? You have? What experience did you have with that? So you built that relationship with them, right?
And we also have people on the team, which is really awesome. And the owner,
right. Yeah, it's really easy for a sponsor to back out if they have no emotional ties to it. I mean, it right now is a hard time. So companies are struggling with money just like everybody else. So if they can cut $1,000 or $2,000, they're going to. And they're going to look at the easiest way to do that. But if they have that emotional tie, that won't even be on the bottom of their list of things to cut.
Is there a particular time of year that's better?
Any time of year. Any time of the year.
Do larger corporations or businesses allocate their money out for the year at a specific time so that it's easier for students to go to basketball? And you're just saying any time of the year.
That's a hard thing to say, solely because every company has different cutoffs. So there are a lot of companies that will have their fiscal cycle will end in June. Some will end in October. October 1st is their new year. Some of them go to December, January to December. So every company is kind of different. Most government agencies or things that are affiliated with the government are going to be October 1st through September, and that's their time frame. A lot of engineering firms, especially if they deal with schools, they're July to June. So it just depends. So I would never stop. I mean, the easiest time to fundraise is the hardest time for the team, and that's during the season. Because if you can get a sponsor to an event, they see what this is all about. That is the easiest way. The easiest way to get that emotional tie is bring them to an event. So off-season events, even, that's another way to do it. So we have Corey here in Ohio. We have that event. It's right in the center of Ohio. That's an easy one to bring people to. Hopefully this event will be a yearly event from now on. So this will be an event that you can bring sponsors to. In fact, I know some teams actually brought sponsors here. Any other questions? No. All right, if you have questions, you can get a hold of me. You can just go to the first website, type in Senior Mentor, and it should bring you to that page. My email address is thood@usfirst.org. Email me with any questions you have, or if you have some good stories to share, please share them with me. I will share them with FIRST and the other senior mentors as well. If you have struggles, let me know, and I can see what I can do to help out.
Applause for our speaker, please.